I know. Don't cry. Don't cry. Don't start. Don't start.
On behalf of Shawnee and Lev, it is my pleasure to welcome you here today. We have come together to this beautiful orchard to celebrate the joining in marriage of Shawnee and Lev. Your love, your encouragement, and your support have been so important to Lev and Shawnee. Each one of you is special to them, and they wanted you to be here today to witness and to celebrate this new chapter in their lives. And in fact, you're so important to them that Lev and Shawnee have requested that you remain here in the orchard for a group photograph after the ceremony concludes. It is a great honor for me to be here today to join in marriage two incredible individuals, Shawnee Delaney and Lev Kaufman. Almost 3 years ago, Shawnee stood where I am now and officiated my marriage. As would surprise nobody who knows Shawnee well, she set the bar very high. And I was understandably nervous when she asked me to officiate here today. Shawnee is a tough act to follow. To legally officiate this wedding in the state of Washington, I signed up online to become a reverend in the Universal Life Church.
Yay!
My Jewish grandparents are very proud. I met Shawnee more than 10 years ago at the start of medical school. Although neither of us remembers the specifics of how we met, I do remember that within a few months, we were planning a 6-week adventure together to Peru. You get to know someone very well, sharing small tents and hostel rooms, being cramped into overcrowded buses for cross-country road trips, and hiking the Inca Trail. Shawnee, of course, accompanied by a 1,000-page hardcover novel. Over the past 10 years, the more I get to know Shawnee, I am regularly reminded of what an amazing woman Shawnee is. Lev, you're a very lucky man.
Yes, you are.
Over the years, Shawnee was a frequent visitor at our house for impromptu barbecues on the deck, often accompanied by delicious wine and American Idol viewings. During residency, these rowdy evenings would usually conclude with Shawnee fast asleep on the favorite area of the sofa. The first time I met Lev was at one of these regular barbecue, wine, American Idol gatherings. As most of you already know, and I quickly learned, Lev is warm, funny, and very easy to talk to. The first time I met him, I could tell how completely smitten he was and how happy he made Shawnee. And when Shawnee told me about his thirst for adventure and love of the outdoors, snowshoeing, hiking into the backcountry, skiing, rock climbing, among others, I had a feeling almost immediately that he was the one. When Shawnee and Lev first met, Shawnee was still an obstetrics and gynecology resident. For Shawnee, this meant that she was often in the hospital for 80 or more hours each week, leaving the house by 4 or 5 in the morning and not returning until well past dinner time. This is no easy test, even for an already established relationship. But Lev, you were always there for her when she came home at the end of these long days. I think you must have realized very early on that Shawnee was worth the wait. And I know Shawnee realized that she had found a very special man. One of the aspects of Shawnee and Lev's relationship that makes them so special is their adventurous spirit and teamwork. As many of you here may remember, Shawnee and Lev planned a backpacking adventure to Nepal in May 2010. They hired a local guide with the intention to spend more than a week hiking and exploring the remote mountains in the Himalayas. However, this trip did not go as expected. In her emails home, Shawnee wrote, and I quote, "Lev and I are here in Kathmandu with only our carry-on luggage and no clothes except for what we are wearing. and I think her luggage is in outer space, or at least stuffed in a corner in the Vancouver airport gathering dust. To make matters more interesting, there is a political strike here in Nepal, and there are no stores open to buy new clothes or replace our trekking gear. Hand washing our lone outfit and underwear in the sink last night worked well, but it's getting tiring. I think many of us, myself included, would may have been on the next plane home if confronted by a nationwide strike and lost luggage that included everything needed for a trek in the Himalayas. Where at the very least, many of us may have spent the vacation in our Kathmandu hotel feeling bad for ourselves. But not Lev and Shawnee. Shawnee informed us in the same email, I quote again, "If none of the stores open for us, our guide may have some extra clothes, gloves, and some plastic to cover our bags. Instead of good Patagonia rain gear with pack covers, we will have large ponchos and plastic bags. We will have to hike in our casual shoes, but we'll tough it out. We will use the local bedding instead of our sleeping bag, and we will wear borrowed clothes from our guide and his girlfriend." Lev and Shawnee worked to find solutions to what they absolutely needed, let all of the extras go, and had an amazing adventure together. They worked as a remarkable team and made the most of a very frustrating and challenging situation. In the pictures from their trek, Shawnee and Lev watched the sun rise over Annapurna with broad smiles etched on their faces, a testament to their ability to overcome adversity together. Lev, Shawnee, this ability is a gift and will serve you well both in marriage and in life. It truly is an honor to be here to celebrate your incredible relationship. I asked Shawnee and Lev what marriage means to them. They both emphasized that beyond love, loyalty, and devotion, marriage means a relationship in which they will always be there to provide support, love, and compassion to one another. For Shawnee and Lev, marriage is about waking up next to their best friend for the rest of their lives. It is about sharing the easy and the difficult, the fun and the tedious, life's joys and sadness, and all of the many unexpected adventures in between. This marriage today is a public statement that Lev and Shawnee have embarked on a lifetime journey together. Shawnee, Lev, I am confident that your marriage will provide you the freedom to fully express who you are, knowing that you will have someone there to catch you when you fall, encourage you when you are discouraged, and applaud all of your successes. Throughout your lives together, may you continuously be reminded of the beauty and deepest intention of the vows you make here today. Shawnee and Lev have asked Sophia, Shawnee's sister, to read a passage from the legal ruling Goodridge versus Department of Health by Massachusetts Supreme Court Justice Margaret H. Marshall. Sophia.
Marriage is a vital social institution. The exclusive commitment of two individuals to each other nurtures love and mutual support. Marriage is at once a deeply personal commitment to another human being and a highly public celebration of the ideals of mutuality, companionship, intimacy, fidelity, and family. It is an association that promotes a way of life, not causes, a harmony in living, not political faiths, a bilateral loyalty, not commercial or social projects. Because it fulfills yearnings for security, safe haven, and connection that express our common humanity, marriage is an esteemed institution, and the decision whether and whom to marry is among life's momentous acts of self-definition. tangible as well as intangible benefits flow from marriage. The benefits accessible only by way of marriage are enormous, touching nearly every aspect of life and death. It is undoubtedly for these concrete reasons, as well as for its intimately personal significance, that marriage has long been termed a civil right.
Oh, very nice.
Lev and Shawnee have asked Danny, Lev's brother, to read the following passage.
So this is a drinking song by William Butler Yeats. Wine comes in at the mouth, and love comes in at the eye. That's all we shall know for truth before we grow old and die. I lift the glass to my mouth, I look at you, and I sigh.
That's nice.
Shawnee and Lev, you are both here today to say your marriage vows to one another. Marriage is the promise of hope between two people who love each other, who honor each other as individuals, and who wish to share the future together. In this ceremony, Lev and Shawnee dedicate themselves to the happiness and well-being of one another in a partnership of mutual caring and responsibility. Therefore, it is all the more important that those of you here today may stand as witnesses to the happiness which they have found together and to the promises that they have made to each other. Will all of you who have supported these two in friendship and love now give your best wishes and support to them? If so, please show them your support by now saying, "We will."
We will.
Lev and Shawnee have written vows that they would now like to read to each other.
I, Shawnee, take you, Lev, as my partner, to embark upon this great journey of marriage with me as my soulmate, my companion. My confidant, the father of my children, my personal spider killer, and my best friend for life. I want you to be my partner, knowing what I already know, and trusting what I do not yet know. Together we will be better than we would be alone. For the good and the bad, I want you to know I will always be there by your side. Thank you. Uh-oh, now I don't have a pocket. I give you this ring as a symbol of my love to you.
I, Lev, take you, Shawnee, as my partner. I am here to show friends and family my love and my commitment. A love and commitment that is already manifest to me. I share with all here today my complete faith to a future with you. I know certain truths. You will be the mother of my children. You will be my life's companion. When you are sad, I will comfort you. When you are happy, I will rejoice with you. When you are cold, I will warm you. When you are warm, I will add more wood to the fire. I give you this ring as a symbol of my love for you.
Shawnee and Lev, you have expressed your love to one another through the commitment and promises you have just made. By the power vested in me by the state of Washington, it is with immense joy that I now pronounce you married. Yay. Lev, you may kiss your bride.
Thank you.